For the Philadelphia Eagles, the 1996 season ended too early in cold, rainy San Francisco in the NFC wildcard game. If anything has become clear in the two seasons that Ray Rhodes has been the head coach, it's that the playoffs are not enough. For Rhodes, there's only one objective, and that's a Super Bowl championship. And Eagles fans know he can take them there. This is a team together, a team making all the right moves. In 1996, the Eagles' offense was the NFC's best. It was an attack that featured the most prolific and the most productive back in the NFL. In addition, the best free agent acquisition of 1996 helped drive one of the league's most dynamic passing games. The defense suffered its share of debilitating injuries, yet still managed to finish among the league's elite. At season's end, they were the fifth best unit in the NFL. And they accomplished this with young talent that's only going to get better. Sure, the ultimate goal, a Super Bowl championship, has not been reached yet. But the Philadelphia Eagles are getting there. There can be no doubt that this team and this organization is headed in the right direction. The 1996 season began in Washington with Rodney Peet at quarterback. He would lead the offense to the NFL's number one ranking through the first 4 weeks.
That goes deep. He's firing for the end zone. He's got a touchdown to Irving Fryer.
The Eagles would win three of those first four games. The offense was sleek, at times brilliant, always multi-dimensional. And while Ricky Waters projected flash and dazzle, he was really more spit than polish, more grit than glitter. Waters rushed for 153 yards against the Lions in the home opener. Then a week later, added 121 more in a convincing win over the Falcons.
Ricky Waters at the 20 and the 10. Ricky Waters for a touchdown. 56 yards.
The victory in Atlanta was also sparked by the defense, which intercepted five passes, including Troy Vincent's first as an Eagle. Rookie free safety Brian Dawkins would get the first pick of his NFL career, while the most versatile linebacker in the NFL, William Thomas, added two of his own. After 4 weeks, the Eagles were 3-1. Next up, the Dallas Cowboys on Monday night at Veterans Stadium. You can't beat it in Philadelphia. Monday night football, a frenzied crowd, and the hated Cowboys. That's about as good as it gets. And the Eagles were ready. They exploded out of the starting blocks. Their first two offensive drives produced points as they built a 10-0 first quarter lead. The highlights, a 41-yard catch and run by Kevin Turner and a bold fourth down call from the Dallas 2-yard line.
They're going to go for it. The game is the one.
But it took just one play for a season of great promise to be cast in great doubt. A ruptured patella tendon would end Rodney Peet's season and leave the Eagles with an uncertain future. Ty Detmer, who had thrown only 32 passes in his four-plus NFL seasons, was now the quarterback. Detmer would perform admirably against the Cowboys. And he would get help from the defense early in the third quarter. But a an evening born of anticipation and expectation ended with a resigned sense of disappointment. Not only had the Eagles lost to the Cowboys, that's tough enough to deal with, but the ramifications appeared to be even more damaging. The Eagles had begun 1996 as one of the NFL's bright lights. Would their impressive start be eclipsed by the loss of Pete, who had won 12 of his 17 starts in Philadelphia? When Ty Detmer made his first NFL start, there were many non-believers. But on that Sunday at Giants Stadium, the inspiration would come from the minister, Irving Fryer. Fryer would make one of the most spectacular catches of the entire NFL season.
Detmer, he's looking, he lets it go, and it is caught miraculously, an amazing catch by Irving Fryer. That is one of the great catches I've seen.
But the keys to the Eagles' fourth victory were another 100-yard rushing performance by Ricky Waters, his third of the season. Four field goals by Gary Anderson. And a defense that did not allow a touchdown. In fact, they gave up just 150 yards of offense. And they put the game away in the fourth quarter with a touchdown of their own. It resulted from one of their season-high 8 quarterback sacks.
Brown hit. Football free. Fight for the ball. Eagles have it. Thomas at the 15, at the 10, at the 5. Ball game over.
Believe me, I'd love to telecommute.
The high point of the 1996 season came during the three-game stretch that began on October 20th against the Miami Dolphins. While Ricky Waters got things started on the Eagles' second play from scrimmage with a 47-yard run, the initial burst in a career-high 173-yard afternoon, this Sunday would best be remembered as the coming-out party for Ty Detmer.
Detmer looks right, looks left, still looking. He is floating it deep, and it is caught. Touchdown!
A week earlier on the road at Giants Stadium, Detmer played a supporting role. Against the Dolphins, the former Heisman Trophy winner was asked to be the leading man on his home stage.
Ground left, both, F right. Sprint right, solid, deep foot drag.
Fire in motion. Detmer on the first down.
Got it.
In his second NFL start, and his second in almost 5 years, since his senior year at Brigham Young, Detmer completed 75% of his passes for 4 touchdowns. Detmer to Fryer, it would prove to be one of the NFL's most productive connections. Against Miami, it set the stage for an impromptu post-game celebration.
Ray Bob's birthday today, so we're gonna sing happy birthday to Ray Bob.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Ray Bob. Happy birthday to you.
One thing I want to say, man, I guess that you guys fought your asses off today. I really appreciate that, man. And this is the best birthday gift a guy could get. It's a win.
Also, we have a game ball to show our appreciation for everything that you do.
Sir,
he puts a lot of hard work in.
Good work, baby.
And he's the best coach in the NFL because of it.
Good work, baby.
A week later, to no one's surprise, the scowl was back. There was another game to play. Another game that had to be won. Against the Carolina Panthers, one of the best defensive teams in the NFL, Detmer would throw for 342. His 42-yard strike to Fryer on the Eagles' opening drive was the catalyst for yet another fast start.
In for the touchdown, Ricky Waters, and the Eagles take the lead.
On a day when Waters would get only 33 yards, it was Detmer who again played the lead role.
Throw. He's looking, he's firing, caught by Jason Dunn.
Detmer and the defense energized the Eagles' third consecutive victory. Two forced fumbles by Troy Vincent, the first recovered by Mike Mamula, and the second with the Panthers deep in Philadelphia territory, helped close out a very impressive win against a Carolina team that would get to the NFC Championship game.
He is hit. He loses the football. The Eagles have it. The Eagles have it. Brian Dawkins.
The rematch with Dallas. This time, the setting was Texas Stadium. It would be a watershed game. It wouldn't be enough for the Eagles to compete. They needed to win. In the NFC East, the Cowboys set the standard.
Gotta have it! Gotta have it!
You measure your own performance against them.
Win on three! One, two, three, win!
When you watch this game, and it was this way right from the Eagles' opening drive, you came away with the feeling that these two teams were evenly matched. A street fight between two of the NFL's heavyweights.
Again goes to Waters, up the middle. He's got a touchdown! Ricky Waters up the middle.
That's good work! That's good work, baby! That's good work!
On this November afternoon in Dallas, it was the Eagles who staked their claim. They made the game's biggest play on both sides of the ball.
Oh, no! Steps up. He is letting it go, and it is caught at the one-yard line. Mark Say. Depper to Mark Say at the one. What a pass.
Quarterback draw zero. Protect the football 1-4. Here we go.
Now you put the pass back in the game. Waters in motion. Depper on a quarterback draw. Is in for the touchdown! Touchdown.
Nice ball by John Gruden. Great ball.
I'm moving so slow, I had time to put moves on.
The Eagles never flinched, and they got another outstanding performance from their quarterback, who, according to his critics, was too small and too inexperienced to handle this kind of pressure. The defense would also play a major role in a frantic fourth quarter that took the Eagles and their fans to the very edge.
James Fuller with the first.
With less than a minute and a half remaining, the Eagles led 24-21. The Cowboys had the ball at the Philadelphia two-yard line. It did not look very good for the Eagles, but it was simply the starting point to one of the most memorable finishes in franchise history.
They give it to Emmett, scraping along the line of scrimmage, and then pulled out of bounds, thrown out of bounds by Troy Vincent. Second and goal for two. Again, Emmett Smith. And again, they stack him up and throw him back up to the yard. Sylvester White. 45 seconds left. Can you stand it?
No.
Oh. Third and goal. Aikman is back.
He is looking. He goes at the end of intercepted. Coming up with the interception.
The Eagles prove they are good enough to beat the best in the NFC East on their home turf. It's not the final destination, but it's a necessary step on the road to the Super Bowl.
Hey, man, I can tell you guys how proud I am of everybody in this room. We talked about making a commitment, to get it done today. And everybody in this room made that commitment.
For Ty Detmer, the toughness issue was put to rest against the Panthers. In the game of intimidation, Lamar Lathan thought he could get the better of Detmer. He was wrong. Detmer would not back down from anybody, and he could take a shot and keep coming back. In the macho world of the NFL, Detmer is a warrior. Put another way, he's a football player first, a quarterback second. In 1996, when times appeared toughest in Philadelphia, Detmer stood very tall. And don't forget, he was a free agent. In fact, the Eagles have been a dominant force in the free agent market. They were the only team to sign another team's transition player in each of the past two seasons. Troy Vincent last year and Ricky Waters in 1995. In 1996, Waters led the NFL in total yards from scrimmage, carrying the largest load of any back in the league. And how about Irving Fryer? 88 catches and 11 touchdowns, and outstanding leadership. He was yet another outstanding free agent acquisition. The Eagles have also drafted very well the last 2 years. Seven starters have come from the last two drafts. Three on the offensive side of the ball, and four on defense. Mike Mamula, the first-round pick in 1995, has been solid at defensive end, while Bobby Taylor continued to emerge as an impact corner. This season, Brian Dawkins proved to be a force at safety, and Ray Farmer added great versatility at linebacker. Offensively, Jason Dunn's 22 yards per catch reflected speed and athleticism not usually found at tight end. And Chris T. Jones, a third rounder in 1995, is the NFL prototype at wide receiver. His 70 catches stamped him as a rising star. This is a team stocked with good, young talent. A team building a championship base at the same time they're competing for division titles.
Hey, every Sunday special. Make this one count, and hey, let's have some fun. Let's get a win. Win on three. One, two, three, win!
That is why the three-game losing streak that began against the Bills at Veterans Stadium, following the emotional win over the Cowboys, did not really change much about the direction the Eagles are headed.
Hey!
The larger view demands that it's not really about seeing 1996 as better or worse than 1995. Keep in mind that all three losses came down to the very end. A play here, a play there. To use that to make firm statements about the Eagles' future is counterproductive and just plain wrong. What happened at Sun Devil Stadium, however, was so bizarre and so out of the ordinary that you wouldn't have believed it unless you saw it. With less than 3 minutes to play, the Eagles trailed by nine. Derek Witherspoon changed that in a hurry.
Witherspoon at midfield, 45-40, 35-30, 25-20, 15-10-5. Touchdown, Derek Witherspoon! There could be life. There could be life.
The onside kick that followed was recovered by the Eagles. It appeared to be another touchdown. But the rule states that you can recover an onside kick, but not advance it.
In the end zone, it cannot be advanced by the kicking team.
Yeah, they can only recover.
It would lead to a Gary Anderson field goal that gave the Eagles the lead with less than a minute remaining and no timeouts for the Arizona Cardinals. Another remarkable victory was at hand, or so it seemed. This would be the Eagles' most difficult loss of the 1996 season. Will face detours. The final four games of the 1996 season would say a lot about the Philadelphia Eagles.
Denver, play action. Back, setting, firing, complete. Touchdown to Jason Dunn!
About 14 as Denver retreats. Denver looks, Denver firing, and it is caught by Irving.
The Eagles shut out the Giants 24-0 for their eighth win of the season. It was a very important game for one simple reason. It restored confidence. But a loss to the Indianapolis Colts followed. And then came an uninspired first half against the New York Jets. Another fork in the road. Another moment of truth. come back. In the NFL, not every week produces a model of precise execution. Sometimes it takes a little intestinal fortitude.
Rolling is Denver. He's looking. He throws. He's got a touchdown. The Christine showdown. Pulling back. Looks towards Anderson.
Once the Eagles gained the lead, it was all over. A fourth quarter interception by William Thomas and a breakaway run by Charlie Garner iced the come from behind victory.
He's got midfield, 45-40. Charlie Garner at the 35-30, the 25-20.
For the second consecutive season, the Eagles would be in the playoffs. And they accomplished that with a quarterback who had never started an NFL game prior to the 1996 season. The goal on the final regular season Sunday, 10 wins.
It's picked up and run in by Michael Mullen for a touchdown. It was knocked by Mamula and recovered by Mamula.
Fueled by Mamula's touchdown in the game's opening minute and the play of Pro Bowl defensive end William Fuller, the team's sack leader with 13, the defense set the tone as the Eagles reached the 10-win milestone for the second year in a row. The final victory on that final Sunday at Veterans Stadium was important for the simple reason that winning is always important. The steps the Philadelphia Eagles took in 1996 may have been small ones, but that must not obscure the larger picture. This is a team and an organization that's clearly headed in the right direction. It begins with the owner, Jeffrey Lurie, who's demonstrated an unwavering commitment to build a championship team in Philadelphia. And then there's Ray Rhodes. This man will not rest until all the pieces are in place. Obviously, the Super Bowl has not yet been reached. But the fact is, you must first be a division champion to have a chance to get there. And make no mistake about it, the Philadelphia Eagles can compete with and beat the Dallas Cowboys. That's been proven. And don't forget, this team convincingly defeated the Carolina Panthers. And they were in the NFC Championship game. The Eagles are one of the NFL's elite teams. Stay the course. The final destination is not that far down the road for a team headed in the right direction.